All right, I was listening to a music compositional study video, and the woman was going into the history of music, what led up to Bach. And she said that Bach was studying two different men before his time. And he said these two men studied outer space. And started bringing the philosophy of outer space into their music. In other words, the mathematical relationship between the planets. You know, Earth is so far away from the Sun. Earth is so far away from Mars, so far away from Jupiter. Jupiter happens to be a different size than Pluto, and all that. And you learn all this by reading Manly P. Hall's book called The Secret of All Ages. But at its heart, so Bach says, oh, okay, so we don't have to create music by placing ourselves in the box of men's traditions, which is the evolution of music, you know. Nobody wants to step out and be an individual and say, hey, let me do things outside the box and just do it my way. Because of prison planet rules and assumptive attorneys, everybody had to follow a humdrum method of creating music that was pleasing to the attorneys of the day who sat on the court judges as court benches as judges. And that was basic. The music was basically a reflection of the rules of society, which said if you live in your houses in the neighborhoods, once you come outside your house into the public square where all the manufacturing plants are at, all the retail stores, where everybody gathers at the parks, for the sake of peace and safety, everybody must behave in a certain way. And you can't behave like you do in your house with the doors and the windows closed. For instance, masturbating. You can't come out in public and just start masturbating in front of everybody. You can't just start ejaculating in front of everybody. When I say masturbating and ejaculating, I'm talking about going out in public and singing in the shower and dancing in the bathroom like you would, or like you dance and sing in the shower in the privacy of your own home and bring it out to the public. Because once you bring it out into and start doing that stuff in front of certain people that aren't used to it, or they get easily offended. So for the sake of the peace and safety of society, or in other words, the order of maintaining order in the prison planet system, keep your personality and all your character behind closed doors in your private house. So that's the way music was created. Keep your own ideas and your own expressions and freedoms of music behind closed doors. Don't write it on paper and bring it out into the public and teach all the public how to play that music, because there's certain people out here in the public that won't like what you do. And they'll get offended and they might pull out a gun and shoot everybody in the town because they don't like what you did. So the judges recognize this for the sake of what's called terrorism or terrorist acts. They said, keep your own ideas and your own expansions and your own freedoms of music, keep behind closed doors. So as mankind finally evolved, they could start slowly but surely bringing those ideas out in the public, because the people that got offended realized that it was a boring world and they wanted to add a little spice to life. So they allowed themselves to put up with freedoms of certain people for the sake of getting themselves out of the monotony of boredom. Because it's pretty boring going through town wearing black clothes all the time, or wearing purple clothes all the time, or wearing squared looking shirts, and everybody wore the same type of pants, and there was no individual character to be expressed. So the basic evolution of man, they finally get tired of the same old, same old. So eventually, music evolved that way too. And so finally, it got to the point where people in the public would say, "Oh, okay, let's get open to a new idea of music because we're bored of the same old music." So that's when the society is ready, and so Bach was one of the key players, instrumental in showing you that you can just make up music any way you want. You don't have to structure it a certain boring way. You can just throw notes on paper, any old ideas, and throw it together. And so that's what he did. And what he did was he came up with different melodies and jumbled them all together in one. And in today's modern time, all that is just a four-piece band, five-piece band, a six-piece band. And everybody gets on stage and they all play their own melodies. The bass plays a bass line, the drum plays a drum line, the guitar one plays a different melody, guitar two plays chord backing melodies, and then you have a vocal singer, he'll sing a different melody, and then you might have backup singers, they each sing different melodies also. So you might have eight melodies, four melodies, three-piece bands, five-piece bands, six-piece bands. And you have the option of everybody playing their own melodies, but it all somehow fits together. And even if it doesn't fit together, one man's trash is another man's treasure. That's just another way of saying one man's way or one band's way of just jumbling melodies and notes together any old-fashioned way is another man's interpretation of, "Wow, look how free they are. They just do whatever they want. Now that's music to my ears." Then you have a combination of people who did that, but they still kept the traditional structure of the pleasing, beautiful harmonies. And so then you have what's called the male and the female together. And so basically, there's your evolution of music, and that's what we're doing today. And so there's the history of music in a nutshell. Now you just apply that same principle to every subject on earth. And shoot, then you can write your own commercial lien and you'll be free. Get yourself out of prison planet, start creating your own reality in life, and put your thoughts on it. Now that's the latest evolution of the mind shift, is putting your thoughts on it so that everybody accepts one another for who they are. No more terrorist acts of pointing the finger and, punching people and cutting their heads off and ridiculing them and calling them names. Just accept each other for who they are. And get yourself used to stuff you're not used to hearing. Just open your mind. And once we start doing that, everybody get along and everything's peace. Everybody puts in their claim lien and prison signs themselves out of prison planet. Then we can move on into the eternal life, where it's just total happiness and bliss, accepting each other. And it's a feeling of ecstasy. You actually feel yourself move into this feeling of eternity. I know that because I've felt it before. It's a whole, I guess the best word to use is it's ecstasy. It's a feeling of ecstasy. And it is a feeling. And it's better than shooting off a load and orgasming. And I can explain more of that later. So, anyway, that's that.